Hi, this is Justin. Welcome to another lesson related with money, and that is simple interest. Now, simple interest is a method used in banks with the money lenders, small companies lending money like the Tala, the Justin platform, and many other platforms, the branch. They use simple interest to do calculation on how much someone is supposed to pay after borrowing money for a period of time. There are a number of three terms that you're supposed to be aware of, and that is the rate, you're supposed to be aware of it. We have the time taken, and we have the principal. Now, these three terms are very important when it comes or when you talk about simple interest. Now, simple interest goes to the formula, and before the formula, R will represent it under working with it. Rate will represent it with R, time is represented as T, and the principal is represented as P. Now, principal is the amount of money that is taken, borrowed, given out. That is the principal. Time is the duration. For how long are we going to stay with this money? 2 years, 3 years, and all that. Then rate changes. Rate is how much are they charging you. When you see something in exam as PM, it means per month. The rate is charged per month. When you see PA, it means per annum. The rate is being charged per year. So if it is 5 years, then that rate goes for 5 years. It's per year. They charge this particular amount. When they talk of PM, then it means it is charged per month. It's very important for you to know this, because maybe given, and then the time taken, you're given a question with the PM, then time taken, you're given 1 year. If you use 1 year during calculation and you use PM, you'll have a wrong answer, because you have to change that 1 year into month, and you refer to it as 12 months. Then you use PM, that is direct. Now, this formula for simple interest is principal times rate times time over 100. This 100 is for the rate. So we have the principal times rate times time over 100. That is equal to simple interest, which you refer to it as I. So when you see I, we are referring to it as interest. So in simple way, interest is equal to PRT over 100. Now let's have an example of this question. You're given a question at all that Kamau borrowed money from the teller, and he borrowed 5,000 shillings, which is being charged at a rate of 10% for 1 month. The rate is per month. How much did the Kamau pay at the end of 1 month? It will be simple interest equals to principal times rate over times time over 100, which is equals to principal is 5,000, borrowed times rate is 10 over 100 times time, 1 month. 0 by 0, 0 by 0. So you pay interest of 500 shillings. So how much will you pay at the end, the whole amount? That becomes amount. Amount is equals to principal plus interest, which is equals to our amount here, our principal here was 5,000. So we have 5,000 plus interest, we have 500. So he will pay a total of 5,500 at the end of 1 month. This is simple interest question. Another example, not exactly an example, another type of question that may appear under simple interest, you may be given the interest. Interest, you have the amount, but you don't have time. So there are about three types of questions that may appear in this simple interest question. And I want us to look at. Now let us look at other questions that are related with simple interest. Remember, we have said simple interest is equal to principal times rate times time over 100. One of the questions that may be asked from this one is, what is time? So when you ask about time, it means they will have given you rate They have given you principal, they have given you interest, so you are missing time. Now, in this question, it means you must have a formula for it. And the formula, you drive it from this formula here. Now, we talk of interest is equals to principal times rate over time over 100. Now, to calculate time, it means we remove all this, bring this side, remaining the time alone. So times 100 here, times 100. That will be 100 interest is equals to PRT. Divide by PR. P is principal, we cancel. R is rate, we remain only time. So time is equals to 100 interest, 100 times interest over principal times rate. That's the formula. In example, you are told, and I want us to use the previous example that we have done, you are told that principal was 5,000 shillings, rate was 10%. So it will be time, we don't know. We don't know time. So we shall come down and say, time is equals to 100 interest over P times R, which is equals to 100 times interest. And in this case, it means as we said, you have been given interest. And let's say our interest, as from the other question, was 5. This is 5,000, so this will be 500. So, with 100 times interest, that is 500, over principal 5,000 times rate 10. We start working out and we shall have the time. 0 will go with 0, 2 zeros, this 2 0, this 1 0, 1 0 there. 5 here 1, 5 here 1. Time is 1 month. Why am I referring to month? If you are told rate is per month. As simple as that. Maybe you need another example related to this one? Okay, let's look at the next type of question. The next type of question that you'll come across is a question where you are asked to calculate rate. Now you're asked rate. So it means you have interest, you have principal, you have time, but you don't have rate. Don't forget our reference question, we shall be reusing this one here, that is principal is 5,000, rate from the previous working, it was 10%, time, it was 1 month, and this percent is per month. Interest, you calculated and found interest to be 500. So we shall use this one as an example, as you work. For now, you don't know this one. So we don't know it. Let's wrap it. We don't know it. It's 10 years, but we don't know it. You have been asked a question now. It's not there. You are told, principal is equals to 5,000. Time is equals to 1 month. Interest is equals to 500. Now, what is the rate used? So we shall come from this question and say, interest, we know it. Principal, we know. Rate, we don't know. Time, we know. How do we come up with a formula for rate? Rate is equals to, back to this formula, interest is equals to principal times rate times time over 100. Times 100 times 100. Over time, times P, over time times P. 100 goes with that 100. Time goes with this time, P goes with this P, we remain with R. So R is equals to 100 times interest over time times principal. This is our formula. Now let's use the formula to see if we shall get the rate that was here. I believe you'll still remember it. That is, from the formula, rate is equals to 100 times interest over time times principal, which is equals to interest, we know already 100, interest is 500, we are substituting a time, we know time is 1 month, and the principal we know is 5,000. Now let's work it out. Two zeros goes with this 20, 10 goes with this 10. 5 year 1, 5 year 1. We remain with the 1, 1 year can cancel, it's just still 1. So we have 1 times 10, and the answer is 10. That's it. I believe you remember we had 10, and here it is. So the formula for finding the rate is rate is equals to 100 times interest over time times P. I want to believe you have understood. So those are the three types of questions that you'll come across. Maybe the last one is the principal. Still using the same question. Now we know rate as 10. We know rate as 10%. We don't know principal, and assume that we have not been given it. So we don't know it. How do you work it out? We know the rate. We know the rate as, we know it as 10% per month. Principal, we don't know. Now, from the question, it means we know the interest, we don't know the principal, we know the rate. So from this question here, let's make our question. We shall say interest is equal to principal times rate times time over 100 times 100 this side times 100 over R times time over R times time. 100 becomes of 100, rate becomes of the rate, time becomes of the time. We remain with principal. So principal is equal to 100 times interest over rate times time. So principal is equal to 100 times interest over rate times time. That's the formula. Let's use it and see. Will we get 5,000? Are we in position to get 5,000? Now, the formula we are having is principal is equal to 100 times interest over rate times time, which is equal to 100 times interest is 500 over rate is 10 times time is 1. So this 1 becomes of the 1. 550 times 100 plus is 5,000. And there we go. Three formulas that you're supposed to be aware of. Principal, in summary, three formulas that you're supposed to be aware when talking about simple interest. One, interest is equal to principal times time, rate times time over 100. The second one, principal is equal to 100 over 100i, and let me say times interest over rate times time. The third formula, rate is equal to 100 times interest over principal times time. And the last one, time is equal to 100 times interest over principal times rate. Very simple formula. When you ask about simple interest, principal times rate times time over 100. When you ask about principal and you have been given the rate and the time, principal is equal to 100 times interest over rate times time. When you ask about rate, we go for 100 times interest over principal times time. And when you ask about time, then we say 100 times interest over principal times rate. I want to believe you have understood. I want to believe you are in position to answer any question that will appear in simple interest. And as you do that, you're becoming smart. Remember, interest is being used in all platforms. As I said previously, that the Tala, the Justin platform, the single, the branch, all of those, the core and all that, all those branches, they do use in simple interest in calculating how much someone is supposed to pay. And therefore, make sure you do more exercise, do more practice. We have books at home. Try to work out these questions, get more vision, and also refer to your teacher, who will be there also to assist you. From Teacher Austin, I say thank you, and I still request you, stay at home. Be safe. We need you back to class. God bless you and welcome. Don't forget to subscribe to Justin, Teacher Austin platform. Thank you. Be blessed.
5, 6, 7, 8.